It's personal between me and I'm going to do you some serious harm, you big stiff idiot.
Back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
I came in and I said, I'm going to get legs. I don't know when he got that explosive. He's popping today. Fucking my shit up.
He seemed real locked in. With this fight being official bullet.
Yeah.
You see something in him?
Well, once we got that official date, I know his mind's flipped. We was already, you know, moving and grooving, but once that motherfucking date hit, he's a whole monster, his mindset right now, so we're good. Yeah.
He to be honest with you, looks a little more locked in than usual.
Yeah, and the weight as a fight being pushed back is really creating more hunger. So, you know, that's the beautiful thing for our team.
This was almost taken from him.
It was almost taken from him, so now he got to take advantage of the opportunity the second time around, knowing that he was clean and knowing that there was no real shit about the allegations. So, I mean, we just never stop. You know what I'm saying? We know what we can do. We're very confident. He has Cepillo, his daddy, myself. We're straight boxing 100% all day, every day. Our team is strong mentally and confidently. You know what I'm saying? He's a main part of the team. He put that work in every day. Every day. Train with Lightweight. Trainer here with us, you know what I'm saying? He missed a day. He's here before us, before me. You know what I'm saying? So I know we ain't missing no beats. So it's gonna be a big fight, y'all. I'm telling y'all. It's gonna be a game changer for him, for his family, like I said before. I'm not changing nothing I said before. He's gonna fucking knock him out. Period.
Everyone agrees someone getting knocked out.
No, ain't gonna be no someone. It's gonna be Titan getting knocked out. Ain't gonna be no someone. Real talk. Fucking work, snappy today, baby.
That contained them heavy ass gloves.
No, when I came in, I told y'all, look at your leg, what I tell you. No, I see them motherfuckers cutting up. The motherfuckers got the striation in them motherfuckers now. That means that speed and explosiveness is there, baby.
Broly, could any chance we actually see that in the fight? Broly fight southpaw?
Oh shit. You know one thing I always tell every fighter is ambidextrous. It just depends on what you put your repetition on. You repeat right hand, you right. You repeat softball, you softball. God didn't make you one hand. You made me both hands. We're all ambidextrous. But it's up to you to put the time in the gym to do it. Let me tell you, the softball, he actually got major power. I'm not gonna say what size, but we're not going to talk our business, but he had major shots from the softball stance. His daddy is a softball, except he is a softball. You know what I'm saying? So every angle we work on is to go with that ball. Saying?
And we've seen guys who are right-handed fight southpaw their whole career, left-handed fight orthodox their whole career.
Right.
So like you said.
Exactly. It's all about the repetition.
My father, he did his first 20 fights in Cuba. He did them as orthodox. And he got used to doing southpaw, he just stayed in southpaw. Mm-hmm. You find it better, you know, better home than southpaw? You know, orthodox, you want those body shots right here, right? Southpaw. And I'm exposed to people. If I remember, motherfucker, a monster with that body shot.
Your pops.
Bro, if that's what they. He's from Santiago de Cuba, that's what they're known for, that body shot. I mean, look at Rigo. Rigo fucking knocked out 10 people straight in sparring with fucking same body shot. I know. Ugas fucking throws that body shot like hell, that same Liverpool shot. I mean, you get explosive motherfucker like him, right?
Well, they say the fighters from Santiago, they're the aggressive Cubans.
Very
they're
aggressive.
The ones that, yeah.
Right, I mean, dude, that's the most dangerous city over there. That city always has problems, you know? It's like, man, my ghetto as fuck, like, compared to like the rest of Cuba. Bob, ponte a la suela, tengo un gancho de quietas.
Go ahead. My hand? Yeah.
Naturally, that's right-handed, right? You're right-handed, right, though, Pops?
Yeah, when I was little, I tried to learn like that.
Yeah. But So you feel comfortable in the southpaw stance, bro? We haven't seen it too often.
Bro, I don't feel comfortable in as an orthodox. Man, you know, man, I'm always like off balance, all sloppy and all this shit. Everybody says I'm the sloppiest fighter in the history of boxing, with the exception of Deontay Wilder. You know.
Well, what do you say about, like, you know, guys like Emmanuel Stewart, Joe Louis back in the day, they would say balance is the secret to a great fighter.
Yeah.
But and people,
Prince,
you know, your critics.
Muhammad.
But Barrera.
Barrera fought him when both of his hands were shattered, and he couldn't make weight no more. That wasn't Hamid. That was weight drained, both hands broken Hamid. I mean, he fought one fight at 130 and retired for a reason because he wasn't the same. I mean, bro, he was fucking pumping cortisone in both of his hands.
So, but yeah, you know, you read the comments. What do you think when they're like, Tank just gonna catch him off balance?
No, listen to this.
Why are they wrong?
Listen to this. I'm gonna say like this. Tank got promoted by Floyd hardcore, right? He has twice as many fights as me. I mean, there's no obvious, I mean, that's an obvious reason why he's a more popular fighter. But I mean, at the end of it, I'm a self-promoted fighter. He became world champion with 16 fights. I did with 12. They found a reason why I was marketable enough to even be in this position. Correct?
Yep.
Yeah.
So I'm one of the most self-promoted fighters of all time, with the exception of, like I said, the YouTubers. The YouTubers, that's a completely different situation because they were already popular. But me, I'm the number one self-promoted fighter in the game. Ain't nobody promote me. I promote me. Or I could be wrong. I don't know if I'm wrong or not, but I think I'm the most self-promoted fighter. Like I said, for me, I have 14 fights. I became the best world champion in the history of boxing. I did in 7 years. I don't know anybody else doing that shit. I became the fastest pay-per-view fighter of all time, with the exception of, like, the YouTubers, but, I mean, they're getting paid per views for how every single view they get paid for. And I'm the first ever canceled fighter in the history of boxing. So, I mean, I'm one of the greatest shit-talkers of my era. I mean...
But we back it up.
But we back it up. We back it up. You know, like... I'm going to just break records and stuff. Like I said... Tank has twice as many fights as me. There's no reason why he shouldn't be more popular than me. But as far as it, if it was Tank on his ammo, without Floyd pushing him, while everybody else is like hyping him up, I bet you anything, he has less followers than me right now. I bet you everything. Because he has no personality. So, and like I said, y'all can say I'm wrong, but he has no personality.
He does sell out his fights. He is one of the few guys.
Yeah, sell out because of Floyd. Not because of Tank. Because of Floyd.
Thank you for watching another video on True School Sports, the home of boxing. If you made it this far, do me a favor and do yourself a damn favor. Hit that subscribe button and surely you will not be disappointed. You know, True School Sports bringing you the latest and greatest, the untouchable, you know, boxing content, interviews, news videos, breakdowns, live fight reaction extravaganza. We've got a great community of people here. Boxing fans all over the world, from America to the UK to Australia. And on and on and on. So join the empire today. Hit that subscribe button. Take care and God bless.